Hi, I'm Larson Halleck, your unlicensed personal trainer. Welcome back to Fist Flicks. Today we're watching one of my favorites, the 2000 epic Gladiator. It vexes me. I'm terribly vexed. So this movie opens up in the jewel of the Roman Empire, a generic American industrial ghetto. We see some guy with a bad haircut walking, and walking, and walking. Protagonist man shoots a brilliant full-court shot, showing that he is down with the urban youth.
You whiting and shoving through my hoops? Punk ass, keep walking! Look at them boots you wearing, man. Stupid ass.
Gladiator. Wait, this guy's supposed to be in school? He looks like he's 30. So do these guys.
You in my seat, boy?
So in the first 3 minutes, our hero has backed down from two fights. Is it too late to put in that other Gladiator movie? Luckily, a sassy black lady diffuses the potentially violent situation.
I'll get you on the greasy side.
The greasy side? If this movie's climactic fight scene involves a deep fryer, I'll have to change my entire opinion of this movie.
Now, before you ladies get pregnant, and you gentlemen murder one another, you will learn the joy of reading. This way, you have something to do in your ninth month, or in your jail cell.
I say the same thing to my students.
Transfer Tommy Riley. Well, Mr. Riley, welcome to paradise.
After school, Tommy takes a quick smoke break with this guy, who, judging by Tommy's hair, I'm gonna call him Milhouse. But then...
Too bad, funny boy. See, trouble be my middle name.
For those of you who aren't down, African American vernacular English uses the word be as the third person indicative of the word to be rather than is.
Well, well, well. Abraham Lincoln.
Here you go, man.
Yes, that is Academy Award winning actor Cuba Gooding Jr. I don't have a joke here. I'm just gonna slam my head into the wall.
I see how my stormtroopers are fan. How are your avenging angels?
Close to God, my brother.
The stormtroopers and the avenging angels. What, were the generic guys and the disco boys not available names?
I'll bleed either way, boy.
Fly, no, you gonna miss.
God damn it, stop hyping me up for fights and then petering out. Yeah, more scenes of Tommy walking, that's what we like.
It's last week's due yesterday. And this week's installment. Due today.
So here's half of a plot. Tommy has to get money. But how? Washing dishes, of course. Gladiator! The camera pans over to see the stormtroopers. Wait a minute, they're in a restaurant. My deep fryer fight's finally gonna happen. Oh, god damn it.
Fight. Box.
Golden Gloves over in Bridgeport.
Did you win?
Yeah.
You fight a few rounds for me tomorrow night, I'll make it worth your while.
How much worth my while?
Oh, now we're talking. Now we're doing business.
So Tommy considers the fighting and goes home. Tommy's dad tells him he's going to be gone a month on a business trip. When your parents away, you throw a party. I know I should have said enter an underground fighting club, but I honestly don't know if that's going to happen in this movie. Dad and Tommy have a heart-to-heart that reveals their relationship on the mend from Dad's alcoholism. Which begs the question, why bother fighting? I mean, it's only going to be a month and your home life doesn't seem that bad, to be honest. So eventually, Tommy decides to fight after the movie shows that he doesn't really need to.
Hi. Try these.
What are these? 6 ounce gloves? Are these even legal?
So this deadly, illegal sport is boxing with slightly thinner Gloves. Gladiator. Oh, you get the idea. This movie sucks. Will it be another blonde, redhead, or brunette? Oh, hey, Milhouse is a fighter, too. So are the stormtroopers. And with that, Tommy's first fight begins, but not before the shadow of the most evil man in history looms over us all. Brian Dennehy. Nice hair, Jagweed. And the fight is on. Tommy Riley, relying on the Rocky Balboa defense early on, he clinches and takes an elbow to the face. I would say that's illegal, but then cornerman Ossie Davis here complains, implying that it is illegal in the context of the fighting. This one's like boxing, except it's boxing. The ref then breaks them up after the groin punch, but then Black Death lands another punch as Tommy is on his knees. So it's London prize fight boxing with... I don't know.
Now!
The guitar just broke a string, time to attack the left side. Tommy wins the day, and oh my god, I just realized how similar he looks to Brian Dennehy.
You like to fight for me, Tommy. I appreciate the offer, Mr. Horn, but I'm not interested.
Come on, kid. If it's a matter of money...
No, it's not the money. It's just that I don't want to end up without a brain.
Don't be stupid, kid. Mr. Horn is giving you a terrific shot here.
Hey. Tommy.
I respect your decision.
Gee, I wonder who the villain is. Personally, I think it's Ossie Davis.
Yeah, you gotta be a real perverse individual. Has some this kind of money.
It's got a bad smell.
Oh, like your Irish sod farmer jacket is any better, Tommy.
Horn wants to see you.
I'm an adult and I can get into the cars of strange men, Dad.
Those pictures, huh? Gladiators, Tommy. They fought with their bare hands.
Unlike the fighters in this movie.
Here you go. Read them and weep.
Take a look at the signatures. Those are markers. Your father's markers. Your father is...
No. Haha, what state is Tommy in with the urban youth? Down.
How come you do it? Save my ass.
I don't know. See somebody in trouble, you know?
I've been in trouble since the day I was born. No white boy come to my rescue.
Do I sense an overcoming of racial boundaries?
I call a baby Black Beauty. That's a nickname.
The music means racial harmony is happening. Anyway, the point of that was that Cuba... No, I don't know his name. Fights to support his child and girlfriend. This is the deadly serious boxing, people. Christ, Rocky IV had dirtier boxing than this. That was Marquis of Queensbury rules. Training montage.
All right, I'm coming.
Damn it.
Hey.
was just...
Come on in.
Tommy is shirtless and sweaty. He can literally not be more attractive to female lead.
But it's illegal, Tommy.
Tommy Riley, the first man to fail the shirtless and sweaty move. Well, this music isn't as good as Rocky's music, but I do like this guy's leopard print workout attire. Yeah, man, never back down. Oh, wait, that's another crappy high school fighting movie. Boy, there's a lot of those. Hey, you can't mix a training montage and a victory montage. I will not allow it. Rico. Suave. Hey. It's a hey, look, he's dancing to Rico Suave. See, he's Hispanic. Do you get it? Huh? Do you get it?
Fighting is not hitting. Any fool can hit. Fighting is making the other fella miss.
Excellent advice from Black President Kennedy. What? That's actually a role Ossie Davis played.
I'm gonna kill that motherfucker.
I'm a bad man, but the ice hurts my delicate skin.
Stick and move, stick and move.
Call me a spick.
So what? You are?
Give it to me.
Give it to me! Come on.
I would do the Apollo Creed death joke, but this movie's not good enough for it.
Papers on my desk.
Can you stay a moment, Mr. Ryan? You haven't been to school for a few days. Can you tell me what's going on?
I'm sorry. I can't.
It's too bad. You have a gift for language, Mr. Riley.
Oh, yeah, all that great writing the movie hasn't shown us at all.
People waste it every day. They abuse it. They take it for granted. Success comes not from what God has given you, but what you do with it. It's really up to you.
Thanks. Hey, Romano, wake up. Buddy, wake up.
Wake up! Congratulations, Tommy. You killed your friend.
All right, I've given you guys your instructions.
Okay, Tommy's fighting Stormtrooper. I assume this is the climax.
That's all right. I ain't going away. Give it to me now.
Come on. That's your new girlfriend, huh? How's Tom? I have to give me a little bit of that.
Congratulations, movie. You invented No Holds Barred a year before schedule.
That's it! Hit him! Hit him! Hit him!
All right!
Come on!
working on a merit badge?
That's some classic Brian Dennehy. I don't get it.
He could die if he gets hit hard.
How many times I've heard that nonsense about bleeds? How many times I've personally seen it disproved?
Your own doctor said that Lincoln needs 60 days rest.
That sawbones, we fired him.
Movie, don't start trying to make commentary about poor treatment of fighters. You have not earned that.
I'm not fighting Lincoln.
Yes, you are.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you're going to fight Lincoln and you're going to beat him and I'm going to make a lot of money.
Come on, sit down. Sit. Here, next to me.
And the fight is on. Not wanting to kill his friend, Tommy spends most of the fight playing defense.
Come here.
I know we're supposed to be concerned about Lincoln's health, but I'm more concerned with what costume designer thought that was a good costume. Oh yeah, all the edgy fight clubs give their ring girls big poofy shoulders.
Milo's heart's gonna hurt my girlfriend, but I'm still not gonna hit you in the head. You're gonna have to kill me!
Damn it, man, I know you're my friend, but I need to buy my daughter clothes.
Fireman!
Come get your money! Go on and do it.
Hey, come on! Lincoln!
If you're gonna do it now!
No.
You don't say no to me, boy.
No. I'm not fighting for you no more.
I have no idea what kind of punch that was, but apparently that not backhand was strong enough to lift a 200-pound man off his feet and over a 4-foot-tall rope.
I want you.
What?
I want to fight you.
You fight me, you win, and you're free. Is that it? Huh? You and your old man? Okay. But if I win, when I win, you fucking little punk, you belong to me. Do you understand?
Yes, this is our final fight. A young, terrible actor versus a middle-aged, paunchy man.
A nice clean fight.
You just stay the hell out of this. This is between him and me. Ain't that right, Tommy?
Hey, whoa. Protect yourself at all times, kid. Oh, look at that face. Look at that face. Come on.
Come on. Hey, you're gonna need that, aren't you?
Come on, take a shot. Here it is, right there.
Go ahead.
The top of the head, kid. Hardest part of the body. Ooh. Hurts, don't it, huh?
Wow, that's actually really clever. Did a few pages of the Tommy Boy script end up in this movie? Wait a minute. Main character named Tommy? Brian Dennehy? Oh god, this is a prequel to Tommy Boy. So our hero wins the day, and he earns his freedom. Yeah, I beat up an old man! And so the movie ends on this image of racial harmony. Hey, what happened to Romano? Who cares about that guy, am I right? Man, this movie eats. I mean, the fight scenes are okay at best, but everything else is mediocre. Well, at least Hugo Danner can be happy knowing that he's no longer the crappiest gladiator in fiction. Oh, come on, somebody has to get that. Should you ever get the urge to watch this, watch Rowdy Harrington's magnum opus instead.
Had time to think about it for a while. Well, I'll walk 200 miles.
He's good.
tastes real good.
How's a guy like you end up in Boston?
Just lucky, I guess.
People who really want to have a good time won't come to a slaughterhouse. We've got entirely too many troublemakers here. Too many 40-year-old adolescents, felons, power drinkers, and trustees of modern chemistry.
Can I buy you guys a drink?
Guess not.
Who is that guy?
The name is Dollar.
I'm Larson Hallett. Keep on training.